Hello, welcome to the Knives Save Lives channel. I'm here
today to talk about this Kershaw 2220 miniature fixed blade. I got this out of town last year. It was at a pawn shop and they had it used there. And I bought it for $20. And I thought, man, that's awesome. I've always wanted to get a miniature fixed blade knife.
And that just fit
the bill. So, especially for the price,
I thought that was a pretty good deal. And, it was easily obtainable for sure. The only problem was it didn't come with a sheath.
So,
I made a sheath for it.
And the video is
actually more about the sheath. Just to be honest with you. I haven't got to use this much yet because I could not carry it.
But a couple of months ago or so, my daughter was doing 4-H. She took a photography and a leatherworking class, among other things. And she brought me home this piece of leather, this big piece of leather. It's kind of funny why she brought it home, because during the school year, Mother's Day, they always make something really awesome for my wife, which is great, except I feel kind of left out. I, like my daughter, were kind of best buddies and whatnot, and so, us guys kind of get the short end of the stick on that, because there isn't any school for Father's Day, not for most places at least. They're out of school for the summer then. So, you know, kind of get left out some. And my daughter was being thoughtful, and she brought me home this piece of leather that she had stamped and done a bunch of work to at the 4-H. And so I had this really brilliant idea, or at least I thought it was brilliant. And I ran it by my daughter to make sure that she wasn't offended by my idea at all. Told her I wanted to make
a sheath for this knife out of it. And she's like, wow, that's a really awesome idea. And I was like, well, you know, I was kind of thinking so myself. And so the other night, a couple nights ago, night before last, in fact, I took that big piece of leather and I just laid my knife over it.
And
I cut out templates or kind of like that. And I cut out three of them, because I wanted it to be stacked three deep so that, well, if it was just the two and it was threaded, the only thing stopping the knife from, there wouldn't be anything stopping the knife from cutting through the threads. So I did three, and the middle one inside is actually hollow to allow for the shape of the knife. So it's all form fit in there. And it's definitely an amateur job. It's the first time I've ever tried to do any kind of leather work in my life, but I'm kind of impressed with it. The threading isn't perfect. The holes aren't all lined up perfectly. You know, it's kind of a rough finish job, but I made a functional sheath for the first time in my life.
And I'm pretty impressed with that. And so that's neat. And it's special, too. But, so what I did was I hand-punched all the holes with sewing needles, not leather needles, and destroyed a good pile of those. In fact, it was really, really quite a pain to try to make this with those types of needles, because they just kept breaking and bending and kept breaking through the thread, and I kept having to put a needle back on it, and it'd do it like right as I was trying to pull the needle through with the thread through a hole, and it was just a real pain. But you know what? I don't give up easily. So I got that done. After I got all the threading finally done, I took epoxy. I put epoxy in all the gaps around this, all the way around, the whole thing so that this would all stick together really well. I was trying to think of some way to sandwich it between something to allow for it to dry without it being glued to something, because that epoxy is like 3,200 PSI when it's dry in strength, and I didn't want to get that stuck to the wrong thing. So what I did was I took some oil and some junk mail, some credit card offers, and I slathered the oil on the credit card offers and then sandwiched it between those, and then I put a board on top of it with a ratchet set and some other tools and stuff of weight on the table to keep it sandwiched and tight through the night. And the next day, it was glued together real well, and then I just took it and I sanded it on my Worksharp 2000. I don't really have much grit left on the one little bit that I have left on the adhesive abrasives for it, but it was enough.
And then I hand sanded it a little bit with 2000 grit.
Or no, 1500, excuse me. And then, you can hear it, it sounds like wood. It's pretty awesome. And then I actually oiled it with some oil after that. And this knife really fits into this sheath very well. I'm trying to do this one-handed, so check that out. That is nice.
Form fit leather sheath. There you go.
For the Kershaw 2220. It looks pretty good with that lanyard on there, too. I did recently learn how to tie a snake knot lanyard, and I've been tying them like crazy. I got them on everything now. Anyway, let me know what you think. And, I mean, I realize it's not professional looking, you know, so you can hold the harsh criticisms.